kayong lahat. Welcome to Pinoy Crossover, guys. The basketball show where all the Filipinos talk in ball. I'm your host tonight, Marky Mark. Over here on my right, we got James. How you feeling today?
Good.
Yeah, like welcome always. Back again, man. We had him for three straight segments. It's been really cool to have him here. And an honorary guest coming back too, making a comeback. Mr. Franz Manila, yeah. How you doing?
Thanks for having me, man.
Yeah, we just wanted to have you so we can talk more about the recent things that just happened in the NBA and trade deadline just happened. So let's talk first about the trade that's happened right after the Raptors beat the Sixers. Tobias Harris to the Sixers. I mean, him and Boban, I mean, Boban is a big part, but let's talk about that Tobias trade to the Sixers. What does this do for the team? Like, what does this say for the Sixers in terms of where they stand in the East?
Well, made them much stronger. Now they can, you know, face against Boston, you know, Milwaukee and the Raptors. So it's pretty much those four teams battling for, you know, the number one spot during the playoffs. So we don't know yet what's really going to happen in the end. But with Boban and, the other trade, that would be a big that's a big acquisition in my opinion. Mm.
Well, this is your Sixers team.
I know, right?
how good did you feel when you saw...
Felt really good, man. Yeah. Just getting a player that who could shoot also. But what really mind blown me is the Clippers. Mm-hmm. Because Jerry West, he's really good at what he does. And he, like, you know, he started the Lakers when he was a GM. He traded Divac for Kobe. And then he went to Memphis, and Memphis made a playoff run. Yeah. Then he went to the Warriors.
And he turned
the Warriors to freaking dynasty or something. And now he went to Clippers. What people don't realize is that Sixers gave him the 2020 draft pick and 2021 draft pick. And 2021 and 2020 draft picks, that's when you can draft high schoolers now. Mm-hmm. Well, one and done is going to be abolished around 2020 and 2021. So it's very interesting that he put him to the Sixers, Tobias, mm-hmm. where he will play against Raptors and Celtics, which is Kawhi and Kyrie. Mm-hmm. If Kawhi and Kyrie don't pass first or second round, who knows? Kawhi might go to the Clippers. This trade's got me like mind blown about like the scenarios of what could happen in the future.
My question to you guys is, okay, for this trade for Tobias, where does this put the Sixers in terms of the ranking in the East? Who's still your first? Who's still your second? Who's still your third?
I don't know.
Does this make them top three, top two?
Make them top three.
Top three? So yeah. So you got what? The Bucks, the Raptors, and...
Actually, I changed my mind. It'll be top four.
Top four? Because yeah, you think four. Boston's still a little bit...
Boston will be third.
Yeah. How good of a fit he is? Yeah, like, is he a good fit to what the Sixers does? More than, I think, maybe Jimmy?
He would be... A perfect fit because of Tobias can shoot three. Mm-hmm. And the only problem is they don't have depth in the bench. Mm-hmm. It's not as good as the Raptors, mm-hmm. not as good as the Celtics. Mm-hmm. So it's going to be a really interesting playoff run because mm-hmm. it's a bunch of rentals going at each other and you don't know what's going to happen next.
Okay. What about, let's take another forward. The Kings are trying to make it, you know, this is the first time they're trying to make a playoff push since the Chris Webber, Jason Williams, Mike Bibby era. Yeah. And they have a really good chance. I mean, they're sitting comfortably in that 6, 7, 8 spot in the West, yeah. on a competitive West. And they acquired Barnes from Dallas. And you know, what's good, you know, their chances? How good is it with adding Barnes to the team, along with their young core of De'Aaron Fox, Marvin Bagley, who's been playing well, Cauley-Stein, and Buddy Hield?
They're going to be really good. Like, you know, they've been pushing lately. They're really attacking teams. Like, I think they're a sleeper. They're actually like a dark horse. Like, you never expected them to make it to the playoffs this year. Mm-hmm. But like you said, you know, they're sitting comfortably in those 7, 8 spot. Right.
I mean, they're gonna get killed by the Warriors in the first round, but still, like.
Oh, for sure. I mean, you gotta they're have a young that, team, yeah. and mm-hmm. you know, down the line, they're really gonna be really competitive. Mm-hmm. And you see them, you know, beating teams you didn't really expect them when the season started. Mm-hmm. So gradually, I think when they get more, like, you know, better players due to drafts, do the trades, and they'll be more competitive. They'll probably like back in the days with Chris Webber, Jason Williams, you know, days, you know, where they'll be really good.
How good of a fit he is to the Bucks? I mean, to the Bucks, to the Kings.
Well, he's a young player. Mm-hmm. That team is young, but the only problem is that they don't have no cap space, mm-hmm. so they can't go for any superstars.
This is them saying we trust our young core, and we're gonna build to our young core with some veterans.
Yeah,
is Barnes, in terms of the championship kind of experience and the championship mentality that he brought from the Warriors, would it help a young team like the Kings, who have a really promising stars in Bagley, Hield, and De'Aaron Fox?
Well, I think it will change a lot of stuff with the Kings. The Kings with De'Aaron Fox, they have upside. The team has upside with Bagley, and then you have Cauley Stein, and then you have De'Aaron Fox, and then now Barnes and Buddy Hield.
That's a good lineup. Mm-hmm.
That could be a good lineup. So what do you think? You think they're going to pass first round? Because you said, you don't think so, but maybe in the future.
Depends on who they face. I mean, if it's the Warriors, it's over. But they're a team to watch. I mean, they're fast-paced. They can shoot. Buddy Hield can shoot the lights out. Barnes can be that stretch four kind of player that they need. So it's going to be interesting. And, I mean, to finish it off, another forward again. Yeah. A big acquisition for the Bucks, Mirotić. What does this do for the Bucks? They're sitting right there at the first place. What does this solidify them in terms of how big of a of a difference this would make to them in the playoffs when they have to face teams like the Raptors and the Bucks and the Boston Celtics or Sixers?
Well, they're already a great team. They're on top of the East, the whole entire NBA. They just even got better, because he's a really good player. When he was in the Pelicans, it was him and Anthony Davis that was, getting the shots, making a lot of points, getting, triple-doubles here and there. Mm-hmm. I think they're really going to be able to compete against, the best, of the East. So it's really going to be it's going to be interesting. It's going to be really tight between those four teams, Raptors, Bucks, Philly and Celtics, so it's gonna be war. Like, you really don't know. It's really up in the air. Who's gonna make it to the finals now? Like, they're really
they're
loading all these players.
They're all loaded up. What does this do for the Bucks? Like, is he a good fit? Like, how good of a fit he is?
I think it's gonna be a good fit because you need someone for Bledsoe and Giannis who can kick out the ball too. So, because Giannis is not really a good shooter. He can shoot three, and Bledsoe too. They can shoot threes, but they're not the best shooters. So someone who will go through the hole and then pass it to Mirotić or Ilyasova. So it will be perfect fit. It doesn't have to be I think they don't need to worry about chemistry. I think it will be perfect fit for the team.
Exactly. I mean, imagine just how good Davis was in terms of how he complimented Davis, and I think Giannis can have the same kind of effect to Mirotić. I mean, it's just that Giannis is just a better ball handler and a better passer. So, I mean, Davis had a career high in assists this year because of the fact that he is able to have shooters around him like Mirotić. And so I think this is just going to help Giannis solidify and just dominate inside the paint and have shooters around him, so then he won't get doubled as much.
Exactly.